Wait, start over.
Yeah, we know you might have heard. Everyone's talking, did you get the word? Look around for clues, but don't get dizzy. Razor News crew got you covered, you feel me? Home of Razorbacks, got trophies on the shelf. But y'all know about the crew in 112. We're as sharp as it gets, running all around. Cameras and mics, we get the news off the ground.
Multiple takes till we get it right. We work hard all day and night. So sit back, chat, and relax, and listen. Razor News ain't got no competition.
Watching Razor News. I'm Eliza.
And I'm Noah. Today is September 16th, 2024.
Hispanic Heritage Month is celebrated from September 15th to October 15th each year.
This month of recognition celebrates the vibrant art, popular traditions, food, culture, and most importantly, Hispanic people who have helped America become what she is today.
The time frame of this month is also significant because many Central America countries celebrate their independence days within these dates.
Beginning on September 15th, Costa Rica, El Salvador, Guatemala, Honduras, and Nicaragua. On September 16th, Mexico. September 18th, Chile. And on September 21st, Belize.
Makeup Picture Day is Tuesday, September 24th. If you miss getting your portrait made, make sure to come to the front when they call for students who missed.
This will be the last chance to have a portrait made for the yearbook.
There's a home football game this Thursday, September 19th, against Honeypath. Come cheer for the C team. Tickets are
free. Shout out to the volleyball team for beating Belton Middle School last week in three sets. They fought so hard.
Special shout out to Leah Goliath for her impeccable serving last week, too. They will play at home today against Riverside and Wednesday at Seneca. Tickets are $5. Good luck, Razors!
Another shout out to our Wahala cross country team. They ran the Green Wave Invitational and swept it up clean. They won the boys JV plus varsity and the girls JV and varsity.
Congrats to our varsity middle school girls. Delaney Gormley with 21:54 and third overall. And Kate Steele with a 24:37. And congrats to our varsity middle school boys. Finn Powell with a 18:05 and 6 overall. Mo Tebow with a 19:33. Hagen Gosnell with a 19:46. And Cade Pitts with a 20 minutes. Good job running. And here are the JV girls and boys times. I would give you guys high fives, but you're just too fast.
FCA meets every morning Wednesday starting at 8 a.m. in the auditorium. All students and staff are welcome.
Here are the national days for this week. There will be a pop quiz afterwards.
Today is National Pet Day Promise Day, so make a promise to your pet.
But it's also National Play-Doh Day, so get creative.
Tuesday is Country Music Day and Get Ready Day.
Get ready for what?
I don't know, but be best ready.
Wednesday is First Love Day.
Aw, but it's also National Cheeseburger Day, which was also my first love.
Thursday is National Talk Like a Pirate Day. Yeah, mateys.
Arg. Let's not ye forget about National Butterscotch Pudding Day, matey.
Friday is National Fried Rice Day.
But it's also Pepperoni Pizza Day.
The special offer for the yearbooks has ended, but there's plenty of time to order one. This yearbook is going to be epic this year, so don't wait too long to order.
Go to jossens.com and search for Wahala Middle School to order.
Payment plans are available.
Speaking of the yearbook, the Wahala Mirror staff needs your help. We are collecting doodles to be used as part of the yearbook design this year.
Drawing should be school appropriate, simple, and bonus if they relate to being a middle school schooler, specifically at WMS, in some way. Use pencil, pen, or black marker. Try to use plain white paper, but it's okay if they're on notebook paper. You can do multiple doodles on one piece of paper, and paper will be submit as many as you want.
Bring your drawings to Miss Howe's room by Monday, September 18th. If your doodle makes it into the yearbook, your name will be credited as one of the part of the design. Thanks to everyone who has already submitted a drawing.
Do you wonder why we need to recycle plastic? Well, we save a lot of energy by reducing greenhouse gas emissions. We could save more than 400 million metric tons of CO2 per year.
Also, manufacturing products from recycled materials saves 30 to 90% of energy needed to manufacture these products from natural resources.
For that reason, we would like to invite you to recycle plastic bottles during lunch time and be part of the challenge.
Recycle your plastic.
Spirit Week is this week. Today is Jersey Day or Sports Day.
Tomorrow is Twin Day, just alike with your besties.
Wednesday is Disney Day. Dress up as your favorite character within the dress code or wear a t-shirt with your favorite character.
Thursday is Purple Out Day. Wear all the purple to get ready for a rowdy pep rally.
Friday is Pajama Day.
That's all for the announcements. Stay with us for the special segments and don't forget to like and subscribe. Bye!
We want to honor the Razors of the Week from last week. The theme was participation. Madison Lusk, Nevaeh Nicholson, Carmani Brazil, Knox Thomas, William Dixon, Rylan Talley, Adeline Bramlett, Logan Simpson, Ben Speedle, Luke Chatfield, Nick Wolf, Ethan Haynes, Iker Hernandez, Reagan Gibson, Bella Snyder, Julian Leon, Mason Addis, Brady Harrelson, Riley Armstrong, Corey Bostwick, Noah Humphrey, Brooklyn Mettler, Isaiah Charles, Leah Francisco, Charlotte Livingston, Connor McCall, Stephanie Hernandez, Yonatan Cherinos, Cadence Duncan, Silas Holiday, Eli Cobb, Connor Childress, Connor Brown, and Ashton Clark. This week's focus will be perseverance. Great job to these students.
More from Razor News, and this is
Mr. Dixon.
And here's the dad joke of the week.
All right, I'm going to make you laugh, okay? Okay. All right, I've been watching a TV show about origami, but I can't watch it anymore because it's pay-per-view. Ooh. Okay, I went to the doctor the other day and told him that I feel like I was addicted to Twitter. He said, I don't follow you. One more, let's see, what else I got? When I was young, I asked this girl to go on a date and to meet at the gym. She didn't show up. That's when I knew we wouldn't work out.
I'm Eliza, and I'm here with
Nada Nunez.
And Miss Zimmerman.
They're going to tell us a disability fact.
I wear hearing aids, and I've been wearing hearing aids because I haven't been, well, I couldn't hear well since I was little, but I've been wearing hearing aids for a very long time.
And some cool things about hearing aids is that digital hearing aids can be programmed to your computer or your phone, and you can turn them up and down with your phone. Hearing aids are very adjustable. They're different than glasses because usually glasses, you put them on and you can see better. But with hearing aids, they have to be adjusted according to the person's hearing. And they can also help with ringing in your ears, different sounds that happen with your ears, and you can put them in and they can help get rid of those sounds.
Thank you.
We're here with
Burgess.
Do you think cereal is soup?
No, it's not soup.
Why do you think that?
Because there's no veggies in it.
Knox. Nah.
Why is that?
Because milk is not in soup.
David Sparks.
It's kind of like soup, yes.
Why do you think that?
Because you put milk in it, it makes it sloppy.
Mr. Powell? I don't think cereal's soup. That's silly. Why? No, because cereal is milk and cereal. Soup is a bunch of ingredients in a bowl, all cooked together.
No.
Why do you think that?
Because soup, it has all the mix-ins. It's in the soup. It's not, like, on top.
Weston Watson. Yeah, it is soup. Because, like, it has liquids and, like, soup has liquids and, like, it has solids in it. And soup has, like, solids in it, too. So, like, yeah, it's soup.
Ashton?
Yes?
Why do you think that?
Because soup has solids and so does cereal.
Sophia? Cereal is not a soup because soup has meat in it and, like, vegetables, and cereal doesn't have that.
Mallory? No, because soup has meat and vegetables and stuff, and cereal doesn't.
Eli Reed?
No.
Why do you think that?
I don't know, because it's not a soup.
We asked, you voted. The legendary debate that divides our school each year is cereal soup.
We received 195 responses online. 77% say no, cereal is not soup. There you have it. That's quite the landslide.
Stay tuned for the special Razor News debate on this topic.
Thanks again for participating, and go vote in the week's poll linked in the description below. Bye!
Hey, what's your name?
Tanya.
What's the Spanish phrase of the week?
¿Qué onda?
What does that mean?
What's up?
What's I love your mustache in Spanish?
Yo amo tu bigote.
Yo amo tu bigote.
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 Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Hello, I'm with.
I'm Aubrey.
What do you think could help change mental health around the school?
I think that schools should let students use like headphones and listen to music when it's personal, like work time.
Carly. Not separating people from the people that they're comfortable with.
Haley Winchester. Less drama.
Cadence Watkins.
Probably like later deadlines, since like children like staying up late trying to like finish it within like the due date is like really just like taking away their sleep and stuff, and like mental health is important around here, so I think that's what would be a good thing.
Noah, I feel like if we got rid of all like the judgmental stuff, it would be a lot more like fun for people, and they won't try to like mess up something.
Naomi.
Naps! Yes!
No more social media, and plenty of activity and Bible studies and prayer meetings.
Rayleigh.
Taking naps whenever we want.
George.
Books.
Let's take a look. That's the books.
Honestly, just being kind to everyone. Like, no name calling, no bad words. Be kind.
Be kind.
Carlos, we talked about this.